In this video, you're gonna get the scientific rundown on what the heck kinesio tape is, what it's supposed to do, and whether or not it actually does anything. Could it actually reduce pain and improve athletic performance? Or is it some silly fad mixed in with a hefty dose of pseudoscience? Well, if you wanna spend a couple of minutes with a geeky physical therapist such as myself, I'll give you the rundown on what the science says and my own anecdotal experiences with it over the years when treating others in the clinic. So here we go. What the heck is kinesio tape? Kinesio tape, or K-tape, which are both shortened names for kinesiology tape, is an elastic or stretchy tape that was invented by a Japanese chiropractor named Dr. Kenzo Case back in the 70s to mimic the elasticity of human skin. Dr. Case noticed that by creating and placing elastic bands of tape over specific areas of the body, that they acted as a new layer of skin and could help with reducing pain and swelling, and could even improve muscle activity and proprioception over the area they were applied. And if you're wondering what the heck proprioception means, we'll get to that shortly. The tape was his brainchild after noticing that traditional, rigid, inelastic tape often impeded movement and performance of his athletes after this tape had been applied. Over the years, kinesiology tape in its applications grew in popularity with specialists such as physical therapists, chiropractors, and other healthcare professionals. And like nearly all other inventions, its methods and applications have been and continue to be refined, expanded, explored, and utilized by practitioners and researchers alike all over the world. Kinesio tape can be used for a handful of different applications, and right before we get into the specific scientific findings for the effectiveness of this tape, it's quite important that we realize that it can be used in a few different ways and that it's not intended to be used in others. And I bring this up since I've often seen individuals draw the wrong conclusions about many types of therapeutic interventions after using them in ways that they were never intended to be used. When it comes to the world of kinesio taping, don't think of it as trying to do the same job as traditional inelastic taping, because it's trying to achieve something different altogether. If we think of humans as a computer system, it may be helpful to think of traditional rigid tape as an intervention for the hardware of the body, such as immobilizing ankles or splinting or bracing fingers, and elastic tape as a mechanism for the software of the body, mainly via the nervous system. Ultimately, we can divide the usage or applications of kinesiology tape into three primary categories: pain mitigation, decompression, and neurosensory input. Let's look at each of these applications in a bit more detail. For pain mitigation, what we're really talking about here is stimulating the skin, which is the largest organ of our body, as a means to essentially distract the brain from pain signals being sent from an area that is producing these pain signals. This distraction phenomenon is known as the gate theory for pain control, or pain gate theory. Now, keep in mind that pain science can get incredibly complex, and I'm explaining things here in a bit more of a conceptual manner for the sake of not overcomplicating the topics in this video. Pain gate theory is pretty cool stuff, and it essentially works by continually stimulating our skin receptors, in this case, using tape. Our skin receptors then send a sensory awareness signal to the brain, basically saying, hey, there's something on the skin right here. It's not harmful, but just thought you should know. These sensory signals travel along a different neurological tract or pathway than the one that the pain signals travel along. And the brain kind of has a hard time focusing on the signals arising from a pain tract and a sensory tract at the same time. So constant sensory input, in a sense, diverts the brain's attention away from the pain signal and gets it to focus on sensations being supplied by the sensory receptors in our skin. Now that's pretty neat stuff, right? It's the same concept as when you bang your shin or elbow on something and then rub it for a few moments to make it feel better. You're making it feel better because you're stimulating your skin to get your brain to block out the pain signals. The slightly geekier way of explaining this phenomenon is that we're turning down nociception, or nociceptive input, to the brain, where nociception refers to the detection of a painful stimulus and the subsequent encoding and transmission of pain signals arising from the sensory nerve endings within the body. When we're talking about decompression, we're essentially referring to the changes we can make underneath the skin. This is accomplished by the elastic nature of K-tape, which, when applied properly, can help lift the skin upwards away from the tissue underneath. This, in turn, can create more space underneath the skin, leading to reductions in edema or swelling, pain, and inflammation. And this can have some rather notable applications, particularly for certain types of injuries, certain stages within injury recovery, and on certain areas of the body. I'll get to the specific scientific findings of this decompression technique shortly, but for now, just know that this is an incredibly powerful technique, and it comes in exceptionally handy for new or acute injuries. When it comes to neurosensory input, I think this might just be the coolest aspect of how K-tape can help the body out when used appropriately. This can get pretty complex, so I'll try and keep it simple and practical without screwing anything up along the way. When talking about neurosensory input, what we're really talking about here is essentially helping the brain to be able to better perceive and interpret what's taking place within a region of the body, particularly when we move. We're not talking as much about pain mitigation here in this category, as rather we're talking more about enhancing the brain's awareness, understanding, and interpretation of movement and positioning of the body part or the joint that's been taped. A lot of this works off of something called Hilton's Law, which states that the nerve supplying the muscles extending directly across and acting at a given joint not only supplies the muscle, but also innervates the joint and the skin overlying the muscle. So what does this mean? Well, it means that we can draw the brain's attention to an area of the body as a means to give it more feedback about what's taking place for the quality and quantity of movement. And we can use this to our advantage to help better perceive and correct our movement and positioning, largely through enhancing proprioception and kinesthesia. Simply put, proprioception is the awareness of the position one or more of our body parts are in, such as our ankle, our knee, or our hip, in relation to the space around us. And kinesthesia refers to the brain's ability to perceive and feel movement that we're producing. The easiest way to understand proprioception is to close your eyes and touch your fingertip to your nose. You'll notice that, barring absence of an underlying neurological condition, you can easily do this without any visual input to assist you. And that's because your brain is gathering information from proprioceptors within your arm to get the positional information it requires to successfully complete the task. And we can enhance these phenomena by strategically placing tape over regions or body parts that require a bit more feedback to the brain as a means to alter or optimize movement. This comes in extremely handy when an individual has a harder time feeling or interpreting how they're moving, and it can make correcting and restoring movement, therefore, much more effective. Basically, you can think of it as your brain having awareness dials to different regions of your body, and that taping these areas can crank the awareness dial up to an even greater extent. So now the scientific breakdown on whether or not using kinesio tape is effective. I'll go through all the scientific findings for these three taping categories here in just a moment, but let's start with keeping the big picture in mind. At the end of the day, studies can often be a mixed bag for determining if kinesio taping is effective or not, but much of the time it comes down to what the study was trying to achieve and how the study was carried out. There are indeed high quality and low quality studies out there that have found various results. So whether or not a single study found kinesio taping to be effective for a particular taping intervention shouldn't mean that we base our entire conclusion from that one particular study. Numerous studies on kinesio taping exist, and it's important to look at the general consensus of these studies. All in all, in the name of keeping this video concise, just know that there's some good research that has shown K-taping to be effective for various aspects of pain mitigation, decompression, and enhancing aspects of neurosensory input. So let's check out the scientific findings for each one of these categories in a bit more detail. When it comes to pain mitigation, the general consensus tends to be that kinesio tape can be a helpful adjunct and one that's certainly better than nothing. However, it's worth noting, and studies often point this out, that combining additional interventions for pain relief alongside K-taping is a good idea. And this is generally what I do with my patients because there are always other interventions I can stack on top of taping. And it's just based on a patient's condition, the type or category of pain that the person is experiencing, and the extent of overall dysfunction taking place. In this sense, I always tell my patients that applying kinesio tape at the end of our session is like putting a cherry on top of the treatment cake. It can oftentimes be quite nice, but there's more to a cake than just the cherry itself. So when K-taping for pain mitigation, this is where I often tell my patients that we're playing with free lottery tickets here, because sometimes you don't win anything, sometimes you have a nice small winning ticket, and other times you can really hit the jackpot of massive pain reduction. And since the worst outcome possible typically tends to be skin irritation, kinesio taping isn't considered to be a risky intervention to try, meaning there's no risk in playing a lottery ticket if it doesn't cost anything to play. Anecdotally, I'd say that about 3/4 of all my patients report that they find some notable form of pain reduction when I tape them, while half of the remaining quarter hit the jackpot of pain reduction, and the other half of that quarter don't perceive the tape to be helpful for altering their pain at all. The decompression aspect of kinesio tape also has some evidence for its effectiveness. It's not a slam dunk, but research has shown that when applied in a specific manner, kinesio tape can indeed increase available space underneath the skin. In research, this is most often measured, at least from what I can tell, by using real-time ultrasound within test subjects. And this allows for visual comparison between pre and post taping over a specific body area. I'd say the most notable study I've come across regarding this decompression phenomenon is is one that's examined kinesio tape's ability to increase acromioclavicular distance within the shoulder, suggesting that it can be helpful for those dealing with shoulder impingement. Shoulder impingement is an incredibly common shoulder issue seen within physical therapy clinics, and I'd say that the majority of my patients with shoulder impingement tend to respond quite well to me taping their shoulder. Of course, there can be more than just decompression effects going on to achieve these favorable responses, but according to this particular study, they're likely getting some decompression benefits as part of the tape's application. But if you want to see the true decompression power of kinesio tape with your own eyes, just do a Google image search for the term kinesio tape for bruising, and you will be met with some seriously cool images showing how specific kinesio taping techniques can significantly speed up bruising, which happens by providing more space beneath the skin for stagnated blood to move out of the injured area at a quicker rate. And it can have the same effects with subcutaneous swelling as well. I mean, honestly, just some of the pictures are incredible, and I've seen this stuff with my own eyes on numerous occasions. The effect of kinesio tape's ability to alter neurosensory input are really remarkable, and there are numerous studies that have shown this to be the case. And there are a lot of studies that have been done here, since neurosensory input is a broad category that can include areas such as proprioception, balance, coordination, tactile acuity, and more. Simply put, what we know about kinesio tape's ability to modify brain activity for these respective neurosensory categories is becoming clearer by the day, with studies like the one by Callahan et al. That showed the effects of taping to alter areas of brain activity associated with sensation, balance, coordination, and other aspects of proprioception. We clearly know that using kinesio tape to improve neurosensory input can have positive effects on our nervous system and thus our movement function. As such, kinesio tape can be an outstanding adjunct for those with ankle instability, shoulder instability, decreased tactile acuity, and more. Essentially, it provides heightened awareness for the brain regarding information on how we're moving and what's occurring during such movement. This extra or heightened feedback allows an individual to become aware of and correct a deficient movement or dysfunctional movement pattern that they might be producing. In turn, this helps them to optimize and restore their movement in a manner that can prevent future issues from arising. I mean, talk about cool stuff, right? So now that you have the basic scientific rundown on kinesio tape and its effectiveness, keep this information in mind for the next time when you may need a bit of pain mitigation, decompression, or neurosensory input for a specific area of your body. And if you want to learn some of the ways I specifically tape for various body parts and injuries, check out these videos where you can learn more about how to do so. And in the meantime, keep making great things happen, and I will see you in the next video.